A massive federal spending bill passes, but not without controversy. The bill contained thousands of pet projects requested by members of Congress. Are earmarks worthy or part of a process that's out of control? UPFRONT asks a Wisconsin congressman. Then, if you're buying a new house, a new car, or a new furnace, you can get some money back. UPFRONT explains some of the credits available through the Economic Recovery Act. And will this former congressman run for Wisconsin governor? Mike Gousha asks him. This week on UPFRONT.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is UPFRONT with Mike Gousha.
Hello and welcome to UPFRONT. Mike Gousha is off this week. I'm Kent Wainscott. Earmarks seem to be the flashpoint in the debate over federal spending. Days ago, President Obama signed a $410 billion spending bill, which contains more than $7 billion in earmarks. An earmark is a spending request made by a member of Congress for a project back home. There were 8,500 earmarks in that omnibus spending bill. Now critics say earmarks are pure pork, but some members of Congress are defending their earmarks as worthy projects. Recently, a Wisconsin congressman moved to restore some control to the earmark process. Representative Paul Ryan is a Republican from Janesville. Thanks very much for joining us once again here on UPFRONT.
Thanks for having me, Ken.
Congressman, you have proposed what you believe is a solution to this problem along with your fellow Janesville native, Democratic Senator Russ Feingold. You have proposed a line item veto for the president that would, in your words, embarrass the pork out of Washington. Tell us how it would work and whether you think Congress really will support this.
Well, Russ and I, just after a number of flights, decided, discussed that this problem is out of control. And so what Russ and I did was come up together with a solution that's constitutional. If you remember, the line item veto that passed in 1996 was knocked down by the Supreme Court. So we actually worked to craft a constitutional version. And I can explain those details if you'd like me, but what we're saying is when the president signs a massive bill like he just did, a $410 billion bill with about 8,500 earmarks in it, he has one choice, sign it or veto the whole piece of legislation. Under what Russ and I, because we're both from Janesville, like you said, we call it the Janesville line item veto. What under this bill he could do is he could sign that bill, pull the pork out of the bill, and then send it back to Congress and make us vote on it up and down. We couldn't dodge the vote. We couldn't filibuster it. The House and the Senate would have to vote on these individual pork pieces on their own merits. That means a member of Congress couldn't tuck their pork into one of these massive 12-inch thick bills the night before we vote on it, which is often how this works, and they would have to go down to the floor of Congress and defend it on their own merits. We believe if that kind of discipline came to the system, number one, the president could sign the worthy pieces, pull out the pork, send it back to Congress. Number two, Congress, by keeping its power, by having the final say-so, makes it constitutional. But number three, members of Congress might think twice about $250,000 to renovate the DuPont family tugboat, about $200,000 to give to a couple convenience store owners in Louisville, Kentucky to advertise their businesses. They'd think twice about money for tattoo removal. They'd probably think twice about stuffing all this pork in these bills if they had to actually face a vote on its own merits.
Critics will say that you have to draw the line someplace. It's really only pork when it's somebody else's district.
Yeah, that's right.
Really, isn't it part of the job of a member of Congress, though, to act in the best interests of the constituents and get something for the district?
And I am not opposed to the earmarking process itself. I believe that there are cases in which earmarks are justified because Congress constitutionally controls the power of the purse. This problem is out of control. It is really just out of control. You have members of Congress in jail today for selling earmarks. You have a constant cycle of campaign contributions going in and earmarks going to private companies coming out. You have one firm called PMA, I don't know what that stands for, PMA Group, a defense contracting lobbying firm that got about $20 million in earmarks. They made $1.6 million in fees on those earmarks to go to no-bid contracts to companies. This is a corrupt system. It's a system that wastes taxpayer dollars. It's a system where you're right. Members of Congress might, there's probably a lot of good earmarks in those bills, but there's a lot of waste in there as well. And we can't afford to have that. We can't keep business as usual in Washington. We don't have business as usual in Wisconsin with this recession, but the problem is Congress is acting as if it's business as usual.
But this is putting a lot of responsibility in the hands of the president to decide what should and should not be
But Congress
left in
makes
the bill.
The final decision. The president takes it out, sends it to Congress. Congress votes on whether or not to rescind it, whether or not to kill the bill or not.
The president signed that $400 billion omnibus bill, calling it a flawed bill because of all of the earmarks in it, but said it was too pressing a need to delay the legislation and push it through, and that he would deal with the earmarks next time around. Mm. How do you think he's done in terms of leadership on this issue?
He should have vetoed the bill. We sent him a letter saying we will help you, Mr. President, by helping sustain your veto of this bill if you veto it based on these earmarks. Look, not only did this bill give an 8.6% increase in spending for bureaucracies and government agencies, it's a lot more than families are getting these days, or even local governments for that matter, but all of these earmarks. He said he was going to take on the earmark culture when he ran for president. I wish he would have taken on the earmark culture now that he is president. The past president, President Bush, didn't do a good enough job on this either, so I'm not trying to be partisan here. I'm just saying that the interests in Congress are so powerful in favor of this earmark culture. And if we can't get this kind of spending right, which is, I would admit, the small stuff from a dollar's perspective, how are we ever going to get the big stuff right?
We've got a lot of earmarks in this bill. You need the support of enough members of
Congress
to get
this through.
Yeah, so
that's our problem. I know Russ and I are talking about that quite a bit as well. The problem we have is the people who write these bills, who put the earmarks in it, they obviously don't like this very much. Mm-hmm. So we obviously have an uphill battle. I passed a version of this bill 3 years ago in the House, got it through. But they killed it in the Senate. Now the Speaker's not even giving me the chance to have a vote on it. Russ has a better chance of bringing it up for a vote in the Senate. Okay. We're making this bipartisan, bicameral, and this, we think, is the recipe for success.
We'll keep an eye on how it plays out. Congressman Ryan, thanks very much for
being with
us. Congressman Ryan didn't request any earmarks in the latest omnibus spending bill. Neither did Congressman Ron Kind of La Crosse, Jim Sensenbrenner of Mequon, or Senator Russ Feingold. But our other Wisconsin representatives requested earmarks totaling nearly $103 million. And here are just some examples. Congressman Dave Obie of Wausau requested $5 million for lighthouse reconstruction at Apostle Islands National Lakeshore. Congressman Stephen Kagan of Appleton requested $1 million to expand the terminal at Outagamie County Airport. Congresswoman Gwen Moore of Milwaukee requested $300,000 for Milwaukee sewer improvements. And Congresswoman Tammy Baldwin of Madison requested $892,000 for the Sand County Foundation, a Wisconsin land conservation group. Though President Obama and the Democrats have talked of earmark reform, you can bet that it's not going to be an easy process. Our political analyst, Jeff Mayers of WISPolitics.com, joins us now from our Madison affiliate, WKOW-TV. Jeff, you heard the congressman. Is it realistic to think that lawmakers will give up their earmarks?
Well, it's tough because line item veto power is giving power to the president. And no matter what party you're in, I think you're seeing this now, Democrats don't want to give power up even to a Democratic president. And so, in the battle between Obama and the Democratic Congress, I think most observers are saying that the president blinked, not Congress.
And I think some people will question whether Congress should give up its earmarks. Really, it's the job of every member of Congress to go to bat for their constituents and to bring home projects and opportunities for their district, isn't it?
Right. I think that this is a real debate. I mean, the easiest way to get something passed is in a budget bill, in a big budget bill, because you know the bill is going to pass. And so that's what's going on. If you had to do these things in piecemeal legislation, they might not pass. And some of them are worthy causes. Senator Cole, for example, had an earmark of $950,000 for Black Hawk Tech in Janesville to retrain GM workers. Well, I don't think anybody's going to argue with it, that that's a bad thing necessarily for Rock County. I think what Ryan and Feingold and others in the congressional delegation are arguing, of course, is that there's been abuses, and so there needs to be reform. It's how to do it.
All right. As always, thanks for your insight. Jeff Mayers of WISPolitics.com.
Thanks, Kent.
Next on Upfront, the government encourages you to buy to stimulate the economy.
Want a new car, truck, or motorcycle? The tax credits that will give you money back for major purchases when Upfront continues.
Upfront with Mike Gousha, brought to you by American Transmission Company, will be right back.